हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल। एंड एज यू कैन सी आई एम हियर विद अनदर वीडियो एंड दिस इज द वीडियो ऑफ एटम्स एंड मॉलिक्यूल्स। एट फर्स्ट लेट अस सी द डेफिनेशन ऑफ एटम्स। सो व्हाट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ एटम? द सिंपलेस्ट form of a matter is atom. So the simplest form of a matter is atom. This is the definition of atom. Now the definition of this molecule, so let's write here, this is atoms. And this is molecule. Molecules definition. So what is the definition of molecules? When two or more atoms are joined, it forms molecules. I hope that you all know what is atoms and what are molecules. Then comes that here matter. This is one term that I have used, which is matter. So what is this matter actually? Anything that you see around you or around us, that is matter. Suppose I take this pen, the outer cover is made of plastic. So in plastic, and plastic is also one matter. And if we are dividing it, going on cutting it, cutting it and cutting it, we will get one simplest form or simplest particle which we cannot further divide, and that is atom, which we call atom. So let's move on to the history of atom. So what is the history of atoms? So history of atom. Actually, the history of atoms come from India. Origin country is India. From where these atoms are, atoms came. Origin is India. Discovered by Maharishi Kanad. Who was he? He was Indian philosopher. What is the meaning of philosopher? Philosopher meaning a person who thinks about our earth, our universe and our world. Means the person who thinks and just relates everything about our universe. Means what is this river, from where is this river coming, from where is this, why are these mountains so tall, each and every details. In the previous time, this philosopher used to think, and now also there are many philosophers. At that time, some philosophers' name we know, Gautama, Siddhartha, which is the founder of Buddhism, we know he was also one philosopher who used to think about life. So philosopher meaning like who thinks about something. Meaning, philosopher meaning is the people, those who people, those who think, is known as philosopher. I'm not going it in the details because this is not the class of that. I'm teaching you chemistry. Okay, so let me tell you one interesting fact, that these atoms and molecule are the first stage which we learn before learning this what? Core chemistry. What is core chemistry? Core chemistry, organic chemistry, inorganic chemistry is a huge, it's a huge topic and all. Do not go with it. Just now what I'm doing, listen it carefully, write down the notes if you want and follow me. So now we have just got the history of atoms, which was discovered by Maharishi Kanad. What he did, he stated, let's now write the statement given by Maharishi Kanad. We will name him as Maharishi. Now, his statements. What are the statements given by him? When any substance in the world is divided further and further, one time we will get a thing which cannot be divisible at all. He named this atom as what? He named this atom as Paramanu. He named this atom as Paramanu. That we say it in Hindi. Actually, he is of India, so he writes it about Sanskrit or Hindi, I don't know. But I'm saying that Paramanu was the name given by Maharishi Kanad. Just remember this. Now, moving on to our next part, which is the part of atom. So, if he named the simplest particle as this, what I have said, Paramanu, if he named that, then from where this atom name comes? That also has some history. So actually we have to remember that person named John, J-O-H-N, Dalton, said John Dalton. Means you can say that without John Dalton, chemistry wouldn't possible. And you couldn't just eat delicious foods like which is made of vinegar, and you cannot get the soap that you use while bathing, and many other things. Our world would just lag down without this chemistry. So thanks to John Dalton. Just go and write in the chat box if you are new about John Dalton, that salute John Dalton, sir. Okay, so without him the chemistry was just you can say one name, or it would be not in this dictionary also if this he didn't say that. He named this Paramanu as atom. What is the meaning of atom? Atom means indivisible. Okay, so atom meaning indivisible. That means थिंग और द सब्सटेंस विच कैन नॉट बी डिवाइडेड फर्दर. नाउ एज जॉल डाल्टन हैज डिस्कवर्ड और नेम्ड दिस थिंग इंडिविजिबल, ही डिड मेनी अदर थिंग्स. He said some laws, he gave some laws also. So what, there are many laws, I'm saying just few of them because which is needed. So the laws which John Dalton stated was atoms cannot be divided further. Number two, atoms can neither be created nor be destroyed. This is the law of conservation of mass. Okay, so at first he taught that atoms cannot be divided further, then he taught that atoms can neither be created nor be destroyed. That means, and other thing, let me write, I'll be explaining that. And other thing he said is that none of the atoms can be same. That means if there is a atom, suppose here is a atom, okay, and here is b atom, c atom, and dot 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 many other atoms. So A atom cannot be like this, that A atom can be found in other thing also, or this atom can be found in many other, or this atom can be of many, like that. So another atom of A cannot happen. There is one type of atom in the whole world. You cannot find that atom anywhere. That single atom without that element, you can find it. Means, suppose I am talking about hydrogen. Hydrogen is one gas, we know. It can be found in which, what are the things that we can get in water? H2O, we know. So in water we get hydrogen. And glucose, C6H12O6, here also H comes, which is hydrogen's symbol. So hydrogen can be found in many things, but this one single atom can't be other. Okay, means A and B cannot be same at all. At all, this cannot be same. He also stated that. Now atoms cannot be created nor be destroyed. That means a single atom, this C, a single atom. See, this C cannot be neither created nor be destroyed. Means I am just destroying it like this. Means I cannot do that, or I cannot write this C like this. Means I cannot make this C, I cannot even destroy this C. You will say, suppose I am saying about water. Now you will be saying that, right, I am just, if I go to my kitchen and if I just means boil water, then what will happen? Our water will be evaporated and will go on. We cannot see the water more. You will be saying that. But actually, if you read this chemistry well, you will get that this water will be converted to gas and will go in our surrounding, go and mix with this air. The water vapor will go and mix with the air. So you can't say that you have destroyed it at all and you have just thrown it out of the world or thrown it out from the earth. You cannot say even the energy also. Energy in case, do not go with energy right now. What you know is that energy means I'm just running now. So I have energy in myself. If I didn't have any energy, I would lie in the bed and would take a rest. But if I have energy, I can run, play, study, watch TV and do all. That thing is energy, you can say. Or this thing, this energy inside me cannot be destroyed or cannot be thrown out of this whole universe. Okay? So enough of discussion about that. So this, none of the atoms can be seen. This is another law. There are many other laws that you do not need right now, but just know these things. If you want, you can take or write the notes. So he said this. So drawback is always there. What is the drawback? Drawback is, in this case, atoms cannot be divided further. Atoms cannot be divided further. It has been further proved that atoms can be divided into three parts. I will be telling you what are those three parts. So this has been drawback. Sorry, John Dalton, that he just one thing got drawback. And what are these three things which can be further divided of atoms? I hope that in future these three will be divided into another sub. Means another and another divided, can be divided further also. So now let us write that atoms can be now divided into three parts. What are those? First is, let's write first one as proton, then as neutrons, then as electrons. I don't hope that you know these types of terms. If you know also, we will be knowing it in detail. Protons, neutrons, electrons. Now let us go further. This thing is known as what? If we write this in a single line, this is known as subatomic particles. So subatomic particles. What are these? Those neutrons, protons, electrons, these are all subatomic particles. Atomic particles for what? These atoms, you can say hydrogen, oxygen, sulfur, sodium, anything you can say. And protons, neutrons and electrons of each and every atom are subatomic particle, which are proton, neutron and electron. Okay, so if in exam these types of things comes, that write all the subatomic particles, then you have to write electron, proton, neutron. Now if question comes that what are these neutron, proton, electron, we'll be discussing it. Now these protons, actually the protons have the positive charge. The protons have positive charge. Protons have positive charge. You will be thinking that what is plus VE? Plus means positive, VE means V, positive. This is the short form of you know, positive, negative, like that. Protons have positive charge. Then comes our neutrons, which have negative, which have neutrons. At first, before this, let us write the electron only, because electron is negative charge. And what is our neutron? Neutron has no charge, actually. Neutron has no charge. Neutron, no charge. As neutron has no charge, then protons are positive charge and electrons are negative charge. If I am saying that if positive charge is greater, then what will happen? The whole atom will just be positive. And now if the electron is just greater than positive, then it will be, then our atom will be negative atom. But when these protons and electrons are same, then it goes to the this atom goes to the relation of neutron, which is nucleus in charge, neutrons in charge. That means it has no charge actually. Now let's erase it. Got that electrons, protons and neutrons, we have something called electron which is exactly equals to protons, which make these stable charge, stable charge. Why is, if their question comes in your examination, then why is why our atoms are stable in charge? Because we know that atoms have electrons and protons in same quantity, then this is stable charge. Because if I say you that you have plus 2 points and you have minus 1 points, then which is greater? If we are going to add it, then what will our answer come? 2 minus 1, which is 1. 1 is what? 1 is positive. As we can see that our charge or our sum becomes positive. Because why is it so? Our positive sign has the greater number. So it is happening. Now if I say minus 2 plus of plus 1. No, not read up this bracket. Minus 2 plus 1, then our answer would come minus 1. So it has minus charge, minus as the total value. But what if means, as we can say that the greater number, yes, and minus sign has the greater number, that's why it is minus in charge. Now what happens if we have this thing, plus and minus both, then we have 0. 0 is neither positive nor negative, which is stable in charge. Okay, so this is the concept that is needed to understand why is electron and proton, if why is this same and why is this stable in charge. Now we got that electrons and neutrons are same and do not again relate that proton and electron are same. Do not say that neutron is also as that. But now comes our topic as atomic mass. What is atomic mass? Atom should have some mass, right? So how will atom have mass? Means anything in the world has mass. This is also one law when you will be studying this measurement chapter. This will indicate you that weight can be zero, but mass cannot be zero of an object. When we will be reading this measurement topic, you will be understanding that why is weight zero and mass not zero. Means any substance in the world will have some weight. Atomic mass is described in Anu. Okay, Anu, which is atomic mass. Like we have gram, kilogram, hectogram, everything. But as this atom is too and too small, we cannot see even with the electric microscope. That's too small. So that's why it can't weigh in gram or kg. It can weigh in a huge small quantity. That quantity is ANU. We say 1 ANU, 2 ANU, like this. Now atomic mass describes in Anu. Anu. So what is atomic mass? Mass of an atom. What describes our mass? Neutrons plus electrons. Electrons describe our Neutrons plus proton describes our mass of an atom. Now you will be saying that why is we are not counting electron, as electron is also a part of atom. So let me tell you one thing, that electron has the weight too small, too less, that it is negligible. If you think it as zero, then no problem. Let's take one example of hydrogen. Whose atomic number, what is atomic number? Atomic number is the series or the number or the rank of this. This is the first rank. Congratulations, hydrogen. Because hydrogen has the lowest electron, neutron and proton. That's the lowest. Its atomic number is equals to 1. Here are many, like hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium, boron, argon. There are many like that. Oxygen, neon, carbon. There are many like this. And let me tell one interesting. This is the first and last is for organization. Organization. What is its atomic number? It's 118. So far, 118 is the largest or is the last atomic number or atom which is known to human beings, which is actually known to human beings. So, organism is the last one, atomic number is the first one. This is last one, but not the least. This is one we always tell, last but not the least. Now, this atomic number we got, the least series, and atomic number equals to 1 of hydrogen. So, we can say that atomic number equals to what? Atomic number equals to number of electrons as well as number of protons equals to NO dot of electron, and this is also equals to NO of protons. So what we can say, what are the number means electrons in the, how many electrons are there in this hydrogen? There are one electron only, as well as one proton only. Now comes our what? Now comes our left side proceeds. Then we will be electrons, protons. We got it that electrons and protons are equal, always equal. Proton means neutrons can differ actually. And now let's draw something. What is this? I've just drawn something like these two circles inside it, that is H. So another thing, what is this? You'll be thinking that, oh, what is this? I don't know. Somebody may know. For those, you actually know that what is it? It is diagram. You will be saying absolutely. This will be diagram only. But what is this diagram really about? Diagram of atom. This is the diagram of atom. Diagram of atom. Diagram of an atom. Actually, this is the diagram of not of an atom, but it is of one arrangement of things. Here, let me tell you one thing that suppose this is one atom, and in the center you will be getting this whole thing. Now, I will be drawing this thing. So understand. Just try to understand that this is atom and this is the structure of the atom. What is this circle and what is this H? H means hydrogen. I am showing about hydrogen, so I have written H. So this circle area is what this I am showing. This is whole nucleus. What is nucleus? Nuclear I have written. What is nucleus really about? Nucleus is nothing, but it's the center of one atom, or that's it. Of one atom, nucleus is center of the atom, where we know we have protons and neutrons in it. So it contains protons and electrons. Protons and neutrons. So where is the electron? You will be saying, where is the electron? Can you see this? This blue colored shaded circle. This is our electron. We got it that our electron moves around this. In what? It moves around in a fixed shell, in a fixed orbit. This is one orbit. What is orbit? We know that solar system has some orbit. Our Earth moves around. It is in the third position. It has some orbit. It moves around. It takes 365 days to cover. And there are many other of unclearly in us. This orbit. It surrounds its orbit. Now, this is electron and protons and neutrons are in the nucleus. So, nucleus is nothing but the center of the atom which just attracts or which is the force which binds these all shells. Which binds these all shells. Now we have got it. So now hydrogen has one electron because it has atomic number as one. Now let's take up another thing. It has been one, so I am writing this as that only. Okay, so the first shell is known as K. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K. First shell is known as K. Shell means orbit is known as K. Then L, K, L, M, then N, then O, and then P. Hardly P contains. Organism contains P, actually P. Okay, organism has that P thing. I'm writing, no, not writing this. So, K, L, M, N, O. Very randomly, just randomly, actually totally randomly, they have chosen K cell at the first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth. There are many of that. When the atoms will be discovered more and more and more, elements will be discovered more and more and more, then this will happen. So what is element? I'll just pronounce this element thing. Element is as same as atom. Means a element consists of only one atom. If this duster contains only one type of atom, then it is one element, or means that atom is also known as element. This has some small elements. That elements we can say hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, there are many other like that. So let's talk about it. So element, and this is what since I have written, I couldn't understand only. It has, element has only one type of atom. Only one type of atom. It has, if it contains only one type of atom, it is known as elements. And compounds are what? Compounds. Compounds, mixture of elements in a fixed ratio. Suppose 2:1 is the ratio of what? H2O. That means water. Water should have hydrogen, two atoms of hydrogen, which is one molecule of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen. This is the ratio. So H2O is one example of compound, and H and O are the examples of what? These are the examples of elements. This is the examples of elements. Now let's erase it. So as I was talking about KLMNO shell. So now if I talk about oxygen. Oxygen's symbol is O and its atomic number is 8. Oxygen's atomic number is 8. Now I'm drawing this is as O. This is O, okay? Don't think it is a cell. And this is first cell, second cell. And no need of that much cell. Now it has 8. Okay. Will I just put each and every electron here? No. There is some systematic rule to put the electrons. Or scientists have noticed that there is one fixed type of arrangement of all the atoms. Atoms, not electrons. So electrons move around our atom, and protons and neutrons stay in the nucleus. They always raise, they have no word. Electron is very hard working person, you treat him very kind and generously. And these electrons, there are 8 electrons actually. As I have said, the number of atomic number is equals to electrons as well as protons. So electrons are in the nucleus in random manner. Do not go with it. Just go with electrons. How are electrons just arranged in one atom? There is one formula, which is 2n square. You will be thinking, what is n? Now n is equals to number of shell or shell number. So the first cell, so cell number is 1. So 2 multiplied by 1 square means 1, so which is 2. So 2 electrons will be there in first cell. We got it from the equation 2n square. So the formula is 2n square, which always regulates the position of electrons in the first, second, third, each and every shell. So 2n square. If I am talking, then I am writing two shells, means drawing two shells here. One is here and here. So in the outer shell, how much is left? 6. Let's check that we have to put 6 or we have to add the shell and do. Let's now see that which number of shell. It is second. So 2n square. N is number of shell. So 2 multiplied by second. Second is that. So 2 square, which is 2 multiplied by 4 and which is 8. It should contain 8. But it has left how much? If 2 is just done, then 6 is remaining, but it can hold 8. So obviously we will have 6 here, and if we have the two more things, then it would be good thing, right? So these are all the basic things. 2n square is the formula to calculate that in each cell what are the things that will be there. And there is the cell, the electrons arranged in this. So this is very much important. This thing is very much important. Now comes our concept as inert gas. Then comes our concept of inert gas. So what is actually inert gas? Inert gas. So inert gas means when it has the full fill of things. When our means when this element will be having the electrons arranged in it in fulfilled manner. That means we got that 2 is in the first shell and 8 is in the last shell. Suppose I am talking about 2 is in the last shell, then it is called as inert gas. What is the example? He. He means what? He means helium. Helium's atomic number equals to 2, whose electron number is also 2. So, in the second shell it will be 2 and it is in stable condition. It do not need to add any electron in it or to give any electron in it, because it has 2 atomic number and it is stable. That means when there is fulfilled, means if the formula is falling in 2n square, then we can say that is inert gas or it is stable condition. It will not react with any other gases. Just listen it carefully, just note it. That what is inert gas? Inert gas means when the 2n square formula is applicable in the electronic electrons arrangement, then it is known as inert gas. Example, helium, neon, argon, krypton, there are many like that. Okay, so go and search in Google, Google master. Google knows everything. We human beings do not know that, but you should remember that. So inert gas concept has also been finished. So what we have learned? Atoms we have learned, molecules we have learned, elements we have learned, many other things also we have learned, mass number, atomic number, inert gas, then electrons, arrangement, protons, neutrons, electrons, subatomic particles, and there is many things that we have just learned. So thank you for today. It's already 42 minutes. So thank you for watching my video and thank you for staying with me for a long time. So meeting you in the next video of this electrons only, and I am continuing my basic language tutorial. Go and watch it, and I will be uploading video soon, and my 1 year is going to complete in 24th April. Do wish me that happy anniversary of my channel. Okay, so thank you. If you want, you can subscribe my channel, and bye bye, take care, and thank you.